the respect for the reading of God's word all over the house. Mark chapter 14. And I'm reading from the New Living Translation. Sermonic spotlight will be on verse 18. Mark 14, 18. If you have it, say, I got it.
I got it.
Amen. I had some water here. Amen. It's on the other side. Praise God. Y'all got Mark chapter 14, verse 18. You will find these words. As they were sitting around the table eating, Jesus said, the truth is, one of you will betray me. One of you who is here eating with me. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the word that we are about to receive for our good and your glory. And everyone said amen.
Amen.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The tag that they've done, they should, the tag that we put on this particular text for today is backstabbers.
All right, come on.
Just real quick, just turn to three people and say backstabbers.
Backstabbers.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody know anything about betrayal? Anybody up in here know anything about being stabbed in the back figuratively by family, friends, and foes? Come on, y'all. Can we keep it 100?
Yes, sir. Back?
Keep it 100.
Keep it 100.
Yeah.
One of the most difficult classes in discipleship is the one about betrayal. Can I just put y'all up on game?
Yes.
Holler back at your boy, go and put me up for a second. Since Christ had to deal with betrayal, that means Christians have to deal with betrayal. However, the question that we need to ask is, how are saints, or folk that are saved, supposed to deal with this kind of deception.
Yeah.
We need to know, how do we handle betrayal that comes from folk that we're cool with and we kick it with?
Yes.
Understand, y'all, betrayal has been around a long time.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, y'all, Cain betrayed Abel.
Yeah.
Hagar betrayed Sarah.
Yeah.
Jacob betrayed Esau. Pharaoh betrayed Moses.
Yes.
David betrayed Uriah.
Yeah.
Delilah betrayed Samson.
Yeah.
And right here we see Judas betrayed Jesus.
Yeah.
Y'all help me preach this thing. Say, oh neighbor.
Oh neighbor.
Believers should expect to be betrayed. That was worth the price of admission right there. I need you to look at two other people and say, oh neighbor.
Oh neighbor.
Believers should expect to be betrayed. When we read the word, it will reveal that all of the gospels record Judas's betrayal of Jesus. And all of the authors say the same thing in scripture. Please keep your Bibles open, because I do plan to preach from it. All the authors say the same thing in scripture. And that text that they tell us is in verse 43, when they refer to Judas. And that was, he was one of the 12 disciples. I'm going to say that again. I used to be slow too. They all say the same thing when they refer to Judas. And that is, he was one of the 12 disciples. And the reason they refer to Judas as one of the 12 when they tell us about the brother's betrayal is because they want us, the readers, to realize that betrayal, point number one, betrayal is always performed by people we would never suspect.
Come on now. Yeah.
I'm trying to help somebody out here today.
Come on.
I'm going to say that again. Point number one. Betrayal is always performed by people that we would never suspect.
Yes.
Understand, y'all, Jesus and Judas were co-laborers in the kingdom. Yes. Jesus, y'all, and Judas shared meals together and served in ministry together.
Yes.
And because these brothers were close professionally and personally, no one ever suspected that Judas would be the brother to betray Jesus.
Yes.
However, the text tells us in verses 17 and 18, it says, in the evening, Jesus arrived with the 12 disciples, and as they were sitting around the table eating, Jesus said, let me hold up for a minute. Let me give y'all the Jackson translation. Nudge your neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
This interpretation ain't in your Bible.
This interpretation ain't in
your Bible. As they were sitting around the table, Jesus said, hold up, wait a minute. Y'all sitting here eating with me, acting like we cool and everything, but y'all need to understand the truth is, that one of y'all sitting at the table eating food I prepared.
Come on.
And the word of the loonies ain't neither one of y'all put five on it. One of y'all up in here is going to betray me. Understand, y'all, Judas was sharing the Lord's Supper with Jesus and the disciples, but no one suspected that it was Judas who would betray Jesus. Let's keep it 100, y'all. We never suspected that the betrayal that we experienced or encountered would be performed by people that we worked with and worship with, by the person that we shared meals with and saw movies with, with the person that raised us or the person that was in relationship with us. Help me preach this thing. Just look at your neighbor and say, oh neighbor,
I never suspected
that person would betray me. Now y'all got to put some strength on it. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you just don't understand. I never would have suspected that it would have been that person that would have betrayed me. I need to know, who am I preaching to? Is there anybody up in here? You like, preacher, you telling the truth. I never would have suspected that it would have been that person that would betray
me. And that's why it was so difficult to deal with. And that's why the betrayal was so shocking and surprising. It's because we never saw it coming. So first, betrayal is performed by people that we would never suspect. But then two, y'all, betrayal is prompted by Satan. I'm going to say that again. Betrayal is prompted by Satan. One, betrayal is performed by people that we never would have suspected. But then two, betrayal is prompted by Satan. Boo, I brought some Bible to back that up. Because y'all looking at a brother like, you know what? Where you got scripture on that? Understand, when we examine this experience of betrayal, we not only have to discuss the what, but we also need to deal with the why. See, we know what Judas did to Jesus, but we don't know why Judas did this to Jesus. And somebody in here is like Judas. You need to know why they betrayed you. I need to know who am I preaching to. Is there anybody else other than me? You just like, brother, since that's what you're preaching on, I just need to know why they did me like they did me. Understand, we need to know why we were betrayed. I got Bible to back that up. In Luke 22:3 and then John 13:2, the reason Judas betrayed Jesus is recorded. For the sake of time, I'm only going to read Luke 22:3. There the text tells us, then Satan entered into Judas Iscariot. Y'all read it too fast. I'm going to say it again. Then Satan entered into Judas Iscariot. In other words, Judas performed this betrayal of Jesus because he was possessed by Satan. Now, y'all, this scripture should suggest to us that betrayal is never personal, but it's always spiritual. Y'all missed the revelation. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, betrayal ain't personal, it's spiritual. Y'all don't know when to shout on scripture. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you just don't understand. Betrayal is never personal, but it's always spiritual. I got Bible to back that up. In Ephesians 6:12, it says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, and against rulers of darkness in this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Understand, y'all, Satan was able to use Judas to betray Jesus because he wasn't saved. Hold up, wait a minute, preacher. He rode with Jesus. He walked with Jesus. He was the treasurer for the disciples' ministry. And you mean to tell me that the brother wasn't saved? I got Bible to back that up too. In John 6:70, the Bible says, then Jesus said, I chose the 12 of you, but one is a devil. Y'all read it too fast. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Jesus chose 12, and one was the devil. Newsflash, the person that betrayed us, guess what? We chose him. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. One of them folk that we chose to kick it with and we kept company with, little did we know that they wasn't saved, and now we tripping because they betrayed us. Betrayers did it because they weren't saved. And that's why, understand, they were able to be used by Satan. And that's why, baby, we need to stop sharing our secrets with folk that ain't saved. Stop sharing our success with folk that ain't saved. And stop sharing ourselves with folk that ain't saved. Because, understand, a believer will always be betrayed by somebody who ain't saved. Y'all ain't saying nothing up here. Just because Judas rode with Jesus didn't mean he had a real relationship with Jesus. Again, your boy need to know who is he preaching to. See, some of us were betrayed by folk that we thought were believers. And in the words of Malcolm X, that's why we were hoodwinked, bamboozled, and run So first betrayal is performed by people that we suspect.
Hallelujah.
Second betrayal is prompted by Satan. But then third, betrayal is a product of selfishness. Betrayal is a product of selfishness. When you get that point of picture, I plucked it right up out of the passage. In Mark 14:10-11, Mark 14:10-11, it says, then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12 disciples, went to the leading priests to arrange to betray Jesus to them. Y'all read it too fast. Y'all got to understand, birds of a feather flock together.
Come
on. Come on.
Judas wasn't saved. And he went to church folks.
Come on.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Just because folk in church don't mean they in Christ. And watch this. So the leading priests were delighted when they heard why he had come, and they promised him a reward. So understand, he began looking for the right time and place to betray Jesus. And understand, y'all, Judas expected Jesus to start a political rebellion and overthrow Rome. And when Jesus came to power, Judas expected Jesus to give him a position with prestige and prosperity. However, when Judas realized that Jesus' kingdom wasn't political, but instead it was spiritual, Judas' desire for the Benjamins made him decide to betray Jesus.
All right.
Because Judas was selfish. He betrayed Jesus. Judas' selfishness caused subversion because he realized that following Jesus, he had a revelation. He realized that following Jesus really ain't about prosperity. It's about ministry. That following Jesus, it ain't about a title. It's about a time. Y'all didn't catch that one.
Hallelujah.
I told them at 8 o'clock to understand everybody ought to have a towel ministry. So what's a towel ministry? See, Jesus wrapped a towel around him when he was hanging out with his disciples. And he, with the towel wrapped around him, dropped down to his knee. Took off the towel. Washed their feet. And began to wipe their feet with the towel that he had wrapped around him. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you gotta have a towel ministry. See, the problem is way too many folk want titles. They wanna be bishop. They wanna be prophet. They wanna be apostle. They wanna be super apostle. They wanna be reverend doctor. Back to Betrayal was performed by people that we least suspect. It's prompted by Satan. Betrayal is a product of selfishness. But then lastly, I realized as I was reading and researching this that betrayal is the Lord's plan for our success.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
You got to work that one out, preacher.
Come on.
Understand. Judas's betrayal of Jesus was part of the Lord's sovereign plan.
Yes.
Oh, bless his name.
Yes.
Oh, in other words, y'all, Judas' betrayal was the cause and the catalyst for Jesus being crucified on the cross.
Yes.
Y'all still ain't got it.
Yes.
I told you I used to be slow too. See, understand, y'all, Jesus needed a Judas. Y'all don't understand. Judas' betrayal was really Jesus' blessing. Oh, understand. Judas meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. I don't know about you, but I got a new praise. What's that praise, preacher? I got a praise for Jesus for blessing us with a Judas. Y'all still ain't get it. Understand, Judas' betrayal was the cause and the catalyst for our blessing. Wait a minute, break that down, preacher. Not a problem. Judas' subversion is responsible for our salvation. Y'all still ain't got it. Jesus had to get to the cross somehow or some way. So he had to find a Judas. Somebody in his omniscience, he knew would never accept him, never serve him. So that made Judas a good candidate. I got a purpose and plan for you, brother. I need somebody to be a Judas so they can get Jesus to the cross so he can be crucified. I thank God for the Judas that God brought into my life. He meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. Because if it had not been for him, I wouldn't be in relationship with him. Is there anybody here? You gotta stand on your feet and praise God for this revelation. Yes!
At any point, the folk that betrayed us could have came to us
But they did. Why? Because of the points that I gave him. So my prayer is, as we move forward, just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
It's God is trying. See, this is opposite. And the Lord is trying to move us forward. But that bitterness because of betrayal and backstabbing is holding us back. God wants to promote us. God wants to take us forward. God wants us to be blessed. And the minute we let it go. We can go into our destiny. Let me hit you with this, because I didn't tell him this at the end, but this is a revelation that I've just got. If you keep reading the story, Judas went to the wrong place and the wrong people to try to make this thing right. Because when he realized what he had done, he went back to them same unsaved people, them same heathens, with that 30 bag of that bag of 30 pieces of silver. This is the silver. He walked up to him and he tried to give it back. He said, I don't want this. They said, we don't want it either. So he just... He realized that he was wrong. But he went to the wrong people in the wrong place to make it right. And he went to Jesus. But because of what he did, guess what? He hung himself. He hung himself.
Yes, he did.
Don't shout on this one. Don't shout on this one. But guess what? Everybody that betrayed us, everybody that backstabbed us, everybody that tried to hang us, end up getting hung on the rope that they was preparing for us. And the word reveals to us what happened to Judas, which means that somebody here knows I'm telling the truth. That's everybody right. That did us. When we wasn't looking for it, when we wasn't asking for it, all of a sudden, they either showed up at the same place that we were, looking toe back, or somebody rolled up on us and said, girl, you know that person and whoever it was and what I saw them, they messed up. The Bible said don't rejoice over it. But the bottom line is that every backstabber, every betrayal, God deals with it. The same way he dealt with Judas. Because the Bible says, harm not my anointing. Every head bowed, every eye closed.